Hello everyone, I'm Seema Singh. Welcome you all in the class of English grammar. Students, in this class, we will learn about the tenses. Okay? I'll show you exactly when to use it and how to use it. And also what mistakes to be careful when we using this tenses. And also we will go through lots of practice exercises together. So you will learn exactly how to use these tenses correctly and confidently. So are you ready? Let's get started. Now students, let us learn about the tenses. Okay, so what do you mean by tenses? Tenses were simply the way we talk about time in English. And what do you mean by the time? We mean the past, present and future. Okay, so for example, when we want to say when something happened, we are using tenses. So in English, there are mainly three kinds of tenses: past, present and future. Okay, so past tense tell us that the action took place. Okay, so it was yesterday. For example, I worked. Next, present tense. Present tense tell us that the action is happening now. So it is today. For example, I am working or I work. Okay. And the future tense. Future tense tell us that the action will take place. So it means it is tomorrow. For example, I will work. Okay. Now student, let us learn about these tenses. You can see here there are three different times and we have different tenses to express or talk about those times. So I want to give you a little overview so that you understand the basic differences of these three tenses. So let me give you an example. In past we would say I ate an apple, but in present we would say I eat an apple. And in future, we would say, I will eat an apple. Okay, so now let us learn one by one. Let us learn about the simple present tense. The simple present tense resembles the base verb, but we add S, ES or IS to a base verb when the subject is in the third person singular, that is he, she, it. Okay, for example, I do, but he does. Or you carry the load, but she carries the load. Okay, so here we see that the base verb do and carry remains the same for the first person I and the second person you. But for the third person, he or she, we need to add ES or IS to the base verb. So students, simple present tense is used to indicate the following. First is habits. For example, he goes for a walk every day. Second is regular actions. For example, the cobbler mends shoes. Okay. Next, third is current situation. For example, Rita is unwell. And fourth, general truths or facts. For example, the sun rises in the east, trees give oxygen, etc. So these all are examples of simple present tense. So now students, let's move towards the exercises. So this is based on the simple present tense. Choose the correct verb to complete the sentences. First, Raman, Phil with his sister, play or plays. Second, Ram, fill, animals, love or loves. Third, I fill to school every day, go or goes. Fourth, we fill rice for dinner, eat or eats. And next, five, my mother fill in a school, teach or teaches. Okay? Okay, here are the answers. Raman plays with his sister. Next, Ram loves animals. Third, I go to school every day. Fourth, we eat rice for dinner. And last, my mother teaches in a school. Okay, so in this way, we make simple present tense. Now, the next one is present continuous tense. So, we use present continuous tense to tell that something happening right now. For example, she is playing hockey. Okay? We use am, is, are and add ing to the main verb to change it into present continuous form. For example, the students are studying in a classroom. So, here we have used are as a helping verb. And study plus ing, studying. Okay, next one is Mr. Rao is driving a car. So here is a helping verb and drive plus ing, driving. Okay, so in this way we form present continuous tense. Now student, let's move towards the exercises that is based on present continuous tense. Okay, so fill in the blanks with present continuous tense. First, Prem and Rajat fill a letter. So the verb is read. Next, somebody fill at the door. The verb is knock. Third, I fill in the park. Verb is walk. And next, fourth, Ria fill a cake and the verb is bake. So let's see the answers. Okay. So students, have a look on the correct answers. First, Prem and Rajat are reading a letter. Second, somebody is knocking at the door. Third, I am walking in the park. And fourth, Ria is baking a cake. Okay, so in this way, we make present continuous tense. So now children, let us learn about the past tense. That is, simple past tense tell us that the action has already happened. So, it is formed when we add the suffix ed to the base verb. For example, the train arrived early in the morning. It means this tense shows an action that happened in the past and is over now. Okay? So students, simple past tense is also used to talk about a past habit. For example, she played hockey. Okay? Irregular verbs do not add ed. They take different forms. For example, he ran very fast. Ria went to the market yesterday. So here, ran and went are the different forms. Now, let's move towards the exercises that is based on the simple past. Okay, so circle the correct simple past tense verb in each sentence. Okay, first, Dhruv wake or woke up at night. Second, my brother teach or taught me how to tie my shoelaces. Third, I send or sent a parcel to my mother last week. And fourth, Rita go or went to Delhi yesterday. Okay? Okay. So the correct answers are Dhruv woke up at night. Second, my brother taught me how to tie my shoelaces. Third, I sent a parcel to my mother last week. Next, Rita went to Delhi yesterday. Okay? So in this way we make simple past tense sentences. Okay? The next is future tense. In this you will learn about future tense, and that is by using the word will or shall before the base verb. For example, I will watch TV after I complete my homework. Okay? The simple future tense shows an action that will happen sometimes in the future. For example, I will be playing in the garden. Okay? Now student, let's move to the exercises that is based on the future tense. So here use the given verb to rewrite the sentences in future tense. Okay, first, they play in the playground. So here we will use will. They will play in the playground. Second, I sleep at 9 p.m. tonight. So the answer, I will sleep at 9 p.m. tonight. Okay. Third, the train leave the station at 12:30 p.m. So the answer will be the train will leave the station at 12:30 p.m. Okay, students. So in this way we form future tense. Okay. So now it's time for recap. Student, we will see what you have learnt in today's class. So in today's class, you have learnt about the tenses and the three kinds of tenses, that is present tense, past tense and future tense. And in future, you have learnt about the simple future tense only. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.